Hello everybody, this is Leslie, and I have a Joann's haul, another one, to share with you all. So just stay tuned and I will show you what I picked up and what the sales were. So stay tuned. Okay. So real quick, when I woke up this morning, I'm still on vacation, so I had seen that they had doorbusters from Thursday till Saturday. I missed out on the doorbusters last week, but they had 50% off of paper products, like paper crafting, and then they also had the fabric quarters that I like to buy. They actually had those 10 for 10, but you need to make sure. In my store, it was ringing up as the 4 for 5 still, which is what I got, the last ones I got for. So it was coming up as $1.25. But I had said to the woman, and I showed it to her, and she says, I'll make sure that everybody knows, you know, at the cash registers, because they did have to adjust the prices because it wasn't coming up as a dollar each. So in case if you do buy fabric quarters, I just want to make sure that you know, make sure you point it out to somebody in your local store, because it may not be in their computer systems as well. I'm finding that with a lot of stores, you really have to make sure that they are aware of certain prices, because they're being put onto their websites and stuff, and then you go to the store and it's just not showing up for the price that they're saying. So you really have to make sure of your prices. So, all right, let's get into it. Okay, so as I said, they had the paper stuff and paper crafting stuff on sale. They also had the stamps and stuff on sale. I want to say these were 50% off as well, but I picked up one of these stamps. This is one of those admission ticket stamps, because when you do collage and stuff, these are actually good to have, just so you don't have to worry about having a physical ticket all the time. You can just stamp it with whatever colors you want to stamp it. So I picked this one up. This was actually $3.99 and I got it for 50% off. So then they had something I very rarely ever see on sale. They had Tim Holtz's stuff on sale. Well, I only have the basic, I have like three, like black soot vintage photo and maybe one other one, I think walnut stain, but I didn't have any of the colors. So with, they were, I want to say they were $8.49, and then they were 50% off. Yeah, they were 50% off. So you're looking at like $3 and change for each one. So I decided to buy Spun Sugar, Stormy Skies, which is a muted blue, like a blue-gray, Speckled Egg, Shabby Shutters, Seedless Preserves, and Festive Berries, because I knew I was going to want a red one. So yes, I bought 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of them. I wanted to buy more, but I said those are the main colors that I really wanted to get. So since I was in need of more of the blending foams, I figured, you know what, let me buy them since they were 50% off. So you get 20 in a package. Then they had no embossing folders. If they would have had embossing folders, I would have picked up a couple of them. These, I think, also too were 50% off. This was $10 it ended up coming out to be. They have these priced so outrageously expensive. I think they had it marked for like $19.99. It is the Tag one. I do have a Big Shot machine. I have to really start using it again. I haven't used it in a long time. But I bought the Tag one because it has a couple of different sizes. So I thought that would be good to have. And what else? I needed pins because I started sewing today and pieces for my Alice in Wonderland journal. So I sewed and I used my brand new pins. Paper. Yes, I bought more paper. They had the Bow Bunny. It's 36 pages, and this one is Botanical Journal Collection. And I really liked this set. And it's got poppies. And then I also liked what they had up here, because you can use these, and I use these all the time. Just pretty. This was really pretty. This I'm thinking I can use in my Alice in Wonderland journal, because this is part of the colors in my journal. Show you everything here. Lots of red. I think these are, and then these are repeats, so you get two of each. So that is the 36 pages of Botanical Journal Collection from Bow Bunny. Then by Bow Bunny, I got the 36 pages of Garden Grove Collection. Again, very, very pretty papers. I love that, the topper, that dark maroon color. Look at that, isn't that pretty? I just thought these were so nice. They are beautiful pattern papers. Absolutely beautiful. Stunning colors. Well, look at that one. Beautiful. Butterflies in blue-gray. Nice neutral. And I think we are back to the beginning again. Yes, we are. So again, that is the Garden Grove Collection. And these are 6x8 size. So, just so you know. Which is a different size. I like these actually better than the 6x6. And then I bought this one. This is by Park Lane. It is called Time Worn Textiles. It is 8.5x11. You get 180 sheets. These are not real thick papers. Okay, I think I'm just gonna do this way, guys. Otherwise, we'll be here all day. A lot of these are really funky, but the ones that are like really far out there are ones that I would use in like background pieces when you're making up ephemera. This would actually be good for Christmas.
So it looks like, I think you get like three of each. This I thought was really pretty. This would be good for Halloween. This also too would be good for Halloween and or Christmas. I thought these were really pretty. These were pretty colors. That was like watercolors to me. That would be pretty for the fall and Halloween. That I thought was really pretty. Even that. So there was a lot in there. So that was why I picked up this one. And like I said, since it was 50% off, I felt that was a good price for it. I don't remember how much it was. I think it was $14.99. And then I got 50% off of that. So for 180 sheets of paper for that amount, that was not bad. Okay. Lace. I bought more lace. Now this lace is hopefully going to be for my journal. So these are the ones that I picked up. Oh, actually I have one more Tim Holtz stuff. Let me pull this out. These are the corners for the books, like when you're doing the journals. So this is for the book corners. So I had picked those up because I didn't have those, and I kind of hoping to do that on a couple of the journals that I make for myself. So I thought this was a good time to pick it up. And I'm going to show you this too real quick. This was a stamp set. It's by Amy Tangerine. And I liked it for the patterns that they had. They have all these different patterns. Like this is like a fabric, a cheetah print, and then just these spots, and then this is like a different type of textile. It also has the calendar, but I liked it for when you're trying to do backgrounds and stuff like on collages. So I thought that would be pretty good. It would, most of them would be used most of the time. So I picked that one up. I don't remember how much this was, but I know it was 50% off. Okay, now these are the laces that I bought. We are going to use this so you can actually see it. And yes, this is a fabric that I've had for Halloween for a very, very long time. And it's like a PVC. But this is one of them. These are the ones that you get by the spool, and they're only $2.99, because when you look at the ones that are, when you're gonna have them cut, they're very, very expensive. So we have this one. We have this one. This I thought would be good for when I do the Queen of Hearts. And I have this one, which is just flowers, because you could use one flower, you can use multiples. Then we have this one. This one was more expensive. This one was $4.99, but I got this for 30% off, I think. That one's gonna be hard to stand up. These we're gonna see, I may have to, we may have to dye them. I may have to coffee dye them. Have that one, and And last one is a large one. This one is that one. So those are the laces that I picked up. So they're kind of, I tried to get them in where I'm not gonna have to coffee dye them. I try not to buy the stark white anymore, but you know, if I like a pattern, I will coffee dye it. I do have a spray bottle with coffee that I do use to spray some of my stuff sometimes, but those are the laces. And again, these were all $2.99 except this one. This one was $4.99. Even this one was $2.99. Last but not least, we have the fabric quarters. Now, we'll show you these first, and I'll show you the other ones because I already sewed them together. But I already have one of these, and I now am going to buy sets of twos. So I have two of these now. I bought two of these. It's like a cream color, like a tan with navy blue flowers, which I thought was really, really pretty. So I bought two of them. Then I like this blue and white flowered. It kind of looks like tiles, like Italian tile. And this one, I liked it for the fall colors with the oranges and the yellows. I really like that. I don't know what I'm gonna do with it yet, but I really like that one. So I had one of these yesterday. Well, not yesterday, my last video. So I needed to get another one. So I ironed the two of them. So they are now ironed. And this is what it's gonna look like. Let me move these out of the way. So I decided I wasn't going to use this for the outside anymore. This may be for the inside of the cover. And then the one that I decided on is this one, is going to be for the outside cover. And I've already ironed it and sewed it together. So basically what I did was I took the seam where they actually had the white part where it tells you that it's made for Joanne and all that, and then I took this part and just did a straight stitch straight down in an ivory. So now what I decided is I'm going to use this part is going to be right in the seam part here. So that's where I'm going to put the seam. I'm going to put it right in the middle here. But when I was looking at the paper, this is the one I want to use as my cover. So when I laid this up against here, I felt that the colors were better for this and having this as the backdrop. In comparison to this one. So this one I think is going to be on the inside cover. I'm going to use this one on the inside cover. And then this one will be on the outside. So that is what I'm going to be working on. All right. So if you haven't already started watching my video on when I put the actual piece together, the actual cover together, I do have the video. I will link it right here for you. So you will get to go there. It's like a 45-minute video, but I had no idea what I was doing with these. All I knew is I wanted to use a bag. And I did tape it, so it is completely taped together. It's a little sneak peek. I did tape this section, this whole section front and back, so this is all taped. The seams are taped. And then I also did on this other side. So that is what I'm going to be working on next. I think I'm going to try and lay the fabric and stuff down in my next video. Okay? So a little sneak peek for you all. So that was what I picked up, and hopefully that's going to be it for me. I don't think I really need anything else. So with that, we will close this video, and I will say, everybody have a wonderful rest of your day. Happy crafting, and I will see you on my next video. Take care, everybody, and thank you for joining me.